Hey guys, it's Jay Bon Jr. here, and let's see what we can do. Let's get down into this. Other than I have to get some upgrades first before I just start. I might get the striker or upgrade my drive, because I do want it to shoot more. So, we got all our upgrades, so I was just going to check if they gave us the, you know, the Dante hair, because they showed off in the last video. So, let's begin this. I'm going to be quiet now.
Welcome to the Order.
Not what I was expecting.
That's the idea. The demons are amongst us, Dante. They are enslaving mankind. The world is asleep, brainwashed, and helpless. We're fighting back. We are a small handful of freedom fighters. We are the last and only line of defense.
Defense? You got no chance.
We don't leave things to chance. We've accumulated vast intelligence on the demons and their collaborators. World leaders, bankers, pop stars. We can hit them where it hurts.
Dante, it really is you. You don't remember me.
No.
How much of your childhood do you remember?
Not much. I had meningitis when I was 7. Wiped my memory. Why?
They told me I had a car accident that resulted in total amnesia. Age 7.
Your point?
Well, meningitis is a human affliction. You are not human, Dante. All war is fought with... My name is Virgil. I established the Order to help find a way to fight the demons.
Besides swords and bullets, you mean?
Such weapons can win battles, but not the war. We use force, yes, but we also use intelligence, politics, propaganda.
You really believe you can make it then?
Make a dent. With the two of us working together, I believe that we can defeat them.
So that's what this is about. You need me to fight the demons, help you save the world.
What else were you planning on doing with your life?
Well, you guys do seem really nice, but I'm more of a loner type. Trust issues, work alone, that kind of thing.
Dante, I don't think you understand what is at stake.
If you want to leave, turn your back on me, I'm powerless to stop you. But you'll be making a grave mistake. Not just for yourself, but for mankind.
For mankind?
Yes!
What makes you think I give a shit?
At least give me a chance to show you.
Show me what?
Who you really are. This was your home.
I don't remember it.
You will.
What are you doing?
Our world and Limbo are very closely superpositioned. They collide in places, causing what we call rifts. It's here, in the rifts, that we can create gateways to and from Limbo.
Doesn't smell too good. What's in the can?
A compound I created based on an old Wiccan recipe. Sea salt, shark oil, iron shavings, desiccated squirrel semen, wolf hair.
Good stuff.
Go ahead. The house holds secrets. I found mine. Now it's your turn.
How'll I get back?
We'll take care of that. Just be careful. It can get rough in there.
I like it rough.
Is this really going to work? He doesn't seem to care.
He's raw. Just like you were when I first found you.
All right. Ooh. I'm gonna check almost every corner for me as possible in this walkthrough. Because I wanna find more red skulls so I can buy more supplies, maybe some golden, what is it called? Those golden orbs, skulls that help you revive. You revive since I am playing on Nephilim level. Even though this game is not too hard here and there, but I'm gonna try to get those. You might hear some background sound. I hope you don't.
So this was my home.
But since I'm in the background, well, you probably won't hear anything.
Show me your secrets.
Hoping. This is where I will plan to do some videos that I couldn't talk in, and I figure how to talk in them now, live doing them, so I wouldn't be speechless and keep talking when after is recorded. But I'm just saying the stuff that I thought that was at the time what happened in the game. And the reason why I'm talking like this is that I heard something and I thought it was a knock on the door. But it wasn't. False alarm. I can't go there yet. I need, what is those little scythe? It's not a scythe, it's like one of those ninjas kunai.
I remember this place.
It comes back to us. This is old Dante house, so there's gonna be a lot of flashbacks and a lot of parts I can't talk into. Some of them I will, some of them I won't. It's just that I just rather not talk through cutscenes because I find it very annoying.
And who the hell are you? Sparta.
Son of Sparta.
My dad.
More monsters coming up. Since I did just kind of start this up and don't really know too much of what of combos right now with my character, because I played the game and forgot half. You could do just with the normal scythe and with the hammer. And also the hammer in this game is pretty good. The problem with the hammer to me is that when you hit one of those weaker enemies, they go flying off. And you gotta make sure that they don't. You have to pick a fight with these guys that you could use the hammer.
You're up on, next.
They don't go flying away like the normal people. And these enemies, you might as well just go behind them after they attack you, and then whip them up in the air and just keep shooting them. And then do some combos there. But make sure there's no one of those chainsaw
that are you trying to show
annoying.
Me?
Later on, when y'all see them, they'll be annoying. The fat dudes, too. I remember they being easy, and now I'm just like, well, I was totally wrong.
Hell yeah!
There we go. hammer. I love this hammer, though, even though it's kind of like you can't really hit any enemy with it unless you're in the air like that. Like, you could also pull out heavy enemies in the air. I'm not the big fan, because that doesn't work. And because of that, you saw me attack in the air, and part of the hammer just rolls off and just hits them. I thought that was nice. Nice addition to the hammer. It helps out with tracking to me. And it's just saying somebody's about to hit you in the air. Just pull out the hammer and just throw your, like, the end piece of your hammer at them. That's cool. Since I don't have the demon evade, I probably love the heaven evade or whatever. You know what I'm talking about when I actually get that build. Well, it's when you use the scythe and you can evade, you can dash evade and start attacking again. I think that was a pretty cool build in this game. And I'm maybe not going to do the Virgil DLC, because the Virgil DLC was like, I don't know if they still have it. And since I don't have the dash, I couldn't get that. But I could surely get the this Lost Soul. I don't know which one gives me more red orbs enemies or these Lost Souls. Because I know Lost Souls are pretty much hard to come by or hard to find. You might need some more special abilities, hammer, you know. The regular occasion. Right here. I think I need the hammer, I'm not sure. No, I need the fist. Yeah, I need the fist. And this kind of like spoiling things, but probably by now y'all saw it. So I'm happy if y'all don't know what I'm talking about, y'all will surely know soon. I'm trying to update that wasn't. Because at the minute I saw him attack, I tried to update every time. But it doesn't work for me. I keep getting hit. Now, if I started out with the scythe, I'll be really, really good. But no. Give me the sword. I should have started on my old count, because you could also just start over and just show you all the cutscenes as well. But I didn't want to do that. I wanted to just show you how it begins. So, not with all the perks and stuff, because it wouldn't make too much sense. He didn't have all that.
Dante, did I hear that right?
And when I first played it, I never had all the abilities. I just bought the ones that were very useful to me. So I never got all the abilities in the game. I'm planning on getting them and finishing everything with Dante, or not really everything, but just trying to get the I'm not sure if I'm gonna do the challenges they have of the doors, the keys. I'm not even sure yet. Because there might be a blooper section for that. Because as many times I played through those types of doing challenges, some of them were hard, some of them wasn't. Getting two tries sometimes. It all depends. And if, like, I find this very useful, when we go up against one of those chainsaw dudes, just lift them up in the air and shoot them. And if you have another chainsaw dude, I'd rather you lift up both of them somehow, make them run at you, something. maybe not run at you because I don't know how to counter that. Before, I did, and I never really died from the chainsaw dudes at all. I wasn't playing on normal because I never played a Deontay game before, so.
That was me. I remember this.
Now here's gonna be a flashback and I need to probably be quiet.
I didn't ask for your help. I didn't ask for your help. I didn't ask for your help.
Okay. I have to note this. Alright. I never really understood. I think this was like his trying to unlock all his abilities. I understand all that. I understand this was going to unlock all his abilities like Scythe or the Claw or anything like that. But what was this dimension world for? Like, was that, what was the statue? That's what I wanted to know.
Where am I?
What was the statue about? Because every time you completed, maybe you'll see in the section, I'm not going to say it now, but I don't know what it was really, who the person was that the statue meant for, but okay. It was just kind of confusing for me. There you go.
Oh yeah.
You earn these abilities quite fast in this game, I might say. Playing a normal Nephilim or anything like that, you kind of earn these abilities pretty fast. If you really want to try the hardest difficulty in the game, I wouldn't really recommend it because it's not like it's hard, like any harder than maybe Black Ops 3. You get shot one time, now dead, or Last of Us, you get shot one time, even in full bar, you're dead. It's the same amount of hardness because you get hit one time, I believe, you just die. It makes sense because it kind of makes sense and it doesn't. The reason why it doesn't make any sense is because he's a Nephilim. He's half angel, half demon. I think he should be able to endure some of the damage that he can put on. You know, kill him instantly type of deal. Because he been impaled and I remember in other games, I never played any of them, saying that again. But I don't believe that he should die easily. And so far for his kind of a devil form or something like that, I don't know what all of that is about, how that turned him white hair. I think it's because it's stressed. I don't know. I think this was his father. I'm not sure. Or the statue was representing his father. I'm really, really not sure. The shackles. I don't know. I don't understand why his memory was kind of chained. But then later on in the story, you still get these some type of flashbacks when it doesn't make too much sense because he should have all his powers after he found out
okay.
the truth.
So what else have you got?
Like that. But other than that, no. Because the more demons he killed, the more abilities that he takes from him, I believe. I think he could do that. That's why he keeps doing the impossible things, like even though he's not really human or anything like that, but he wants to a little bit. Here. Pull that, and then we're gonna go through that door. That's what I know too. I love it about Dante. I don't know too much about him.
They're here. They fell consumed us.
What the hell happened here?
We've got to get out.
To me, he was just like one of those lost kids that teenagers that drink so much and they care for life. But he did, obviously. After all this, he cared more. He just wanted to know a little bit more about himself than anything. That's when he started to care. Now, I think they could have did something like, you know, since I'm just going to keep rambling on about the story, I do think Virgil would have been a really good hero, and the way he turned on to be at the end was a great thing. I'm just talking about this now since I played through the game, and I want to just say this out in this video because, hey, I didn't particularly like how it went. Even though I know what Virgil's like plan was doing and stuff like that, I don't understand. Like, you get all these people to help you and you still think humans are not all this great people or anything like that. You still find them below you. And I really didn't understand it. Elise, come on, man. You used us and you did that and that in the game. Talking about in the game. And you still don't find us a little bit as you, because you was kind of powerless just to go up against the King Demon yourself. You needed help anyway. So Virgil just turned evil instantly, and I just know that.
Is that?
Because I really believe that they could have went a different path in this game and made another one saying maybe more demons came like up in the ranks. And I think now that they just completely ruined that because they were supposed to start over again. I understand they was going to start over again, but they could have made a lot more of this year. Or the game in general. Yeah, those, since you have the claw, you can do all that. Well, I would recommend it doing a lot of that. Take out the heavy guys first. Do not take out the heavy guys first. They might be causing you a big trouble when you come fight the little guys. Even though the normal guys can hit you and stuff like that. And especially in Nephilim World, they're not causing any of the threats. Trust and believe. Even though they get a couple hits on you and you have a really low health, aim for the big heavy dudes. Here's my favorite weapon, almost my favorite weapon in the game. I'll say the shotgun. Because when you get surrounded, that can pop. I like the shotgun. Because what he does with it's crazy. I used to spam the circle with the cipher. I really did. And then I'll cancel it out with the pistols. But I failed to understand to do that. I probably won't do that at all. But when you spam the cipher, it gets powerful. Even more powerful. And then you can gather more monsters into the site. That's why I like the weapon, because it's more like a long range type of deal. You can spin it around and get a lot of damage. Because the more shinier it gets, the more powerful it maxes out. And I'm just totally just crazy these guys. It was pretty easy. When I get my scythe or anything like that, I know what I'm doing.
Down there! Cover the doors! Move!
That's a good move, but they also can leave you open when you saw he did it double. He doubled the the circle up combo with Scythe, that can also leave it open. That's why I use it a lot, but it does backfire sometimes. I think I should have did the circle.
Cool.
I just wanted to cut it up normally. I can't go there yet. Anna.
I blew her up.
I wish it was more spiders on the ground. And this is where I get the claw, use my power right. The Heavenly Claw, the Angel Claw. And also, they said in this game that the father was banished and stuff like that and never returned, and he had the ultimate punishment, and mostly he's still alive. That's nice. What I couldn't understand. If he was alive, right? Why they could not just break him out at least? Like he was, you know what I'm talking about. Maybe he wasn't in that realm or where he's gonna go further in the story. Because I spoiled enough in this video, but I will mention it when I get to that part in the game. Because I found that very stupid. Like, he could probably save his father, or maybe not, I'm not sure. I don't know how it goes. But they said he wasn't dead in this game. He might have been, but I'm not sure. As I said, I'm not experienced being on Devil May Cry, but I do know how to play this game pretty well. Let's get on up here. Break this. Another chain.
What am I unleashing?
And also, like I know, I'm not gonna say it, but I'd say it at the end of the video. More of those little creatures. Now they got shields. Even though that is the useful move, the up move, throwing the bomb, throwing right back down. I also believe that you probably most of the time won't even use them. They just show you that so you would know how to time it and stuff like that. But most of the time you'll be trying to mostly just hit them. in the air and take their shields off and like swipe them like 3 times or twice and just kill them pretty easily. Probably won't even be doing any of that at all. Fairly easy. Let's keep going. Probably get out of here.
I remember my mother. Her name was Eva. She gave this to me. I had a brother too. We were a family. I had no idea of the danger we were in. The demons found us. When they broke in, I saw him.
That was just cruel.
She gave her life so that we could escape. I will never forget what he did to her. Our father, Sparta, took my brother and I away. He separated us, hid us safely amongst the humans, wiped our memories to protect us.
Okay. All went black. Can you please, guys, can you explain the white hair with Virgil, please? Like in the comment section below, if you know the story of Dante and his family, because I believe, like, if you had the white hair, that all your abilities were unlocked automatically, because his abilities start unlocking when he had all his, like, his hair start turning white, because of his devil trigger. So, what was the meaning of Virgil having white hair when he was beginning, like, or when he was a kid? What was the meaning of that? But Dante had black hair from his father. I would at least think his brother would at least have black or red hair, because his mother.
I'm getting out of here.
Or orange hair, something. Not just, you know, regular. Well, not regular, but white hair.
Keep going.
Let's get on out of here. Another cutscene.
Brother.
Your twin brother. And I've been looking for you for a long time now. Our mother gave these to us. I think she knew that this moment would come, that we would find each other.
And our father, Sparta?
Banished forever. A fate worse than death, they say. He's never coming back.
I want to know more. Where we come from, what happened to us. And above all, I want to know who's responsible for all this.
All right, guys. Even though that was a long part of the game and it was like nearly like 30 minutes throughout the whole thing, thank you for watching and stuff like that. Leave a comment, like, and subscribe for more of my content. And I'll see you guys later. Thank you for coming. Peace. J-Budger out.